Hello everyone, this is the first class for the course Bioinformatics, Introduction to Bioinformatics. In this class, we are going to discuss what is bioinformatics and what are the applications of bioinformatics. After the life science research has understood that genes are responsible for the entire functions of the cell, people started focusing to know more about the genes of various cells and organisms. And it was also identified that genes are encoded by the process of central dogma, where genes are first transcribed and they are translated into proteins. Proteins are responsible for various functions of the cell. After this realization that genes are responsible for all the characteristics of the cell, people started sequencing the entire genome of the cells. That's how the whole genome sequencing projects have come into picture. As a result of this whole genome sequencing projects, you will have lots and lots of nucleotide sequences available. So when for many organisms, when these nucleotide sequences become available, how to manage this data? That has become the challenging task. That's where bioinformatics has come into picture. In order to organize or manage this huge amount of data and then later to analyze this data. Likewise, with the available huge information of nucleotide sequences, people also started working on genome-wide microarray analysis, high-throughput protein analysis in order to understand the functions of the proteins. All this analysis, different types of analysis in larger quantities, resulted in large amount of data, which has become a challenging task to manage this data. That's how bioinformatics has come into picture, to manage this large amount of biological information. And then later the challenging task is how to analyze this data into a meaningful information. With this large amount of data that has become available, various technologies, new technologies have come into picture. The way here it is mentioned, the new technologies that have emerged are, depending upon the type of data we are studying, genomics, which deals with the complete genetic information of the particular cell. Similarly, we have transcriptomics, which studies the RNA information of a cell. Similarly, proteomics. Proteomics deals with the complete protein content of a particular cell. Metabolomics studies the metabolites that are present in a cell. What are the developments towards bioinformatics? With these different types of new technologies that have emerged, managing the information has become a challenging task. So something needs to be done in order to maintain this large amount of information and to analyze this data. That's where bioinformatics has come into picture. Bioinformatics is meant to translate data into useful biological, medical, pharmaceutical, and agricultural knowledge. So with this introductory information, now we can define bioinformatics as storage, analysis, and searching or retrieval of biological data. Here, biological data in the sense, it can be a nucleic acid sequence, meaning it can be a gene sequence or RNA sequence, amino acid sequence of the proteins, or the structural information of proteins. And there are two terms you need to precisely understand. One is bioinformatics and other one is computational biology. Many times people get confused between these two words. What is bioinformatics? Bioinformatics majorly deals with the database-like activities. As we have discussed earlier, it tries to organize the large amount of biological information in the form of biological databases. And it also provides the tools to retrieve these sequences from biological databases. Whereas computational biology, it deals with the development of tools, computational tools, which are required to analyze the biological data. And also, it explains how to use these tools to analyze the biological data. So bioinformatics majorly deals with the database-like activities, whereas computational biology, it deals with the development and usage of computational tools to analyze biological data. This slide explains bioinformatics as a multidisciplinary approach. Bioinformatics requires the knowledge of many fields of sciences. Not only that, bioinformatics is also useful in many branches of life science research. That is why bioinformatics is considered to be multidisciplinary approach. So as we discussed, bioinformatics requires the knowledge of many branches of science, which include computer science, biology, biotechnology, informatics, information technology, and also statistics, physics, and electronics, which is why it is considered to be multidisciplinary approach. With this, I hope you understood why bioinformatics has been started as a new branch of science. What is the definition of bioinformatics? Now we are moving on to understand various applications of bioinformatics. Of course, bioinformatics started in order to manage the huge amount of biological information which is derived from the genome sequencing projects and other projects. We have very large amount of information in the form of databases. Next, the challenging task is to analyze this information and to interpret some meaningful conclusions out of this information. So the major applications of bioinformatics include to uncover the wealth of biological information which is hidden in the mass of nucleotide sequence. Once we know the nucleotide sequence, we can also understand or we can also translate it into amino acid sequence based on the nucleotide sequence. After knowing the protein sequence, we have the methods to determine the three-dimensional structure of proteins. Knowing the three-dimensional structure of a protein, we would be able to understand the functional aspects of proteins. The major applications of bioinformatics include uncovering the biological information which is present in the nucleotide sequences, meaning what are the coding sequences, what are the regulatory sequences. Such information can be derived from the nucleotide sequences that are present in the databases. Later, deriving the amino acid sequences of those genes and then knowing the three-dimensional structure. Based on the three-dimensional structure, we will be able to understand the function of proteins. In addition, the other applications include, so whatever I have discussed in the previous slide about nucleotide sequence, protein sequence, all that can be done using sequence analysis methods. Other applications include in silico prediction of drug or pharmacoinformatics. This is nothing but applying these bioinformatics tools in the process of drug designing, that is known as pharmacoinformatics. If you are able to apply these bioinformatics tools in the field of agriculture, that is called agroinformatics. We can also use these bioinformatics tools in drawing the evolutionary relationships of organisms, which is called phylogenomics or evolutionary studies. There also we can find the applications of bioinformatics. And one more important application where we can use bioinformatics is in maintaining the literature in the form of databases and also retrieving the literature from these literature databases. So now let's see a few more details about each of these applications. As I listed, the applications of bioinformatics first comes is sequence analysis. The sequence information is analyzed using bioinformatic tools in order to determine the regulatory sequences as well as coding sequences. This can be done by the method of sequence alignment. Sequence alignment is the method which is used for analyzing the sequences using bioinformatics tools. What are the different sequence alignment methods? How many different types are there? How the sequences are aligned using these alignment tools? All that will be discussed in the upcoming classes. So with the sequence analysis application, we can also compare the genome sequences of different organisms within the same species or different organisms between different species. So when we compare the genome sequences of the organisms, we would be able to understand to what extent these organisms are similar or dissimilar. The next listed application is in silico prediction of drug or pharmacoinformatics. As I mentioned earlier, if you are able to apply these bioinformatics tools in the process of drug discovery, this branch of science is called pharmacoinformatics. As you guys know, drug discovery is a very complex process. There are several steps involved in this process, right from the identification of drug target, then identification of lead compounds, if required, synthesis is to be done. Later, you need to study the pharmacokinetics, pharmacodynamic parameters, and it undergoes several stages of clinical trials, which is a very cumbersome and lengthy procedure. It takes about 7 to 10 years of time for one drug molecule to release into the market. So what I'm trying to explain is that it is a very lengthy and time consuming process. If you are able to apply these bioinformatics tools during the process of this drug discovery, that will speed up the process. This pharmacoinformatics can be again divided into two different parts. One is pharmacogenomics, then other one is pharmacogenetics. Pharmacogenomics is nothing but the application of genomic technologies to identify the drug targets. This part of study is called pharmacogenomics. Similarly, we also have pharmacogenetics. This is otherwise known as personalized medicine. What is this personalized medicine? One drug molecule will not respond in the same way for all the individuals. Few people with one particular type of drug, they recover very fast, whereas few individuals, they show very slow response or little response. Few of the individuals might develop allergic reactions, or few might end up with side effects also. All these variations are because of the genetic makeup of different individuals. If we are able to prescribe the medication based on the genetic constitution of a particular individual, that would work much better. So this personalized medicine or pharmacogenetics, it deals with the prescription of treatments based on the genetic profile of individuals. So this is about pharmacoinformatics, which includes pharmacogenomics and pharmacogenetics. Hope you guys are following. We are discussing about various applications of bioinformatics. Next comes is agroinformatics. The application of bioinformatics approaches in the field of agriculture are known as agroinformatics. Mainly, it concentrates on the sequencing of genomes of different plant varieties which have got agricultural importance, and also the sequencing of genomes of farm animals. When you have the genome sequences of these plants and animals, we would be able to search, or we would be able to analyze the genes which are responsible for good characteristics of the organisms or plants or animals. When we are able to identify such genes, we will be capable of producing the crop varieties which are stronger, more drought, disease, and insect resistant varieties. Similarly, in case of animals, we would be able to improve the quality of livestock to yield more production of milk, meat, and we would be able to produce the healthier varieties of animals. So these are the applications of different applications of bioinformatics approaches in the field of agriculture. Next is phylogenomics and evolutionary studies. If you are able to compare the genome sequences of different organisms within the same species or different organisms that belong to different species, we would be able to understand to what extent these organisms are related to each other, which will help us in understanding the evolution. Likewise, these bioinformatics approaches can be applied in order to understand the evolutionary relationships of organisms, which is studied as phylogenomics or evolutionary studies. There are several software which are used for this phylogenomics. Three are listed here. One is Phylip. Phylip is nothing but phylogenetic inference package. POP is phylogenetic analysis using parsimony method. One more software that can be used for phylogenomics is Clustal Omega. So this Clustal Omega and how these different bioinformatics tools are used for studying phylogenomics, that we will be studying in the later classes. This is just the introductory class to make you understand what is bioinformatics and what are the different ways bioinformatics can be used. The last application that is listed over here is literature retrieval. Whoever the scientist, whatever the research they study, all that needs to be published in different journals. That all we know. It is published in the form of research articles. Most of the journals these days, they also publish in electronic format. All this journal information or the research articles are organized and maintained in the form of literature databases. One such very huge database available for literature is PubMed, which is maintained by NCBI. NCBI is National Center for Biotechnology Information. It's a database of citations and abstracts. For any journal, the citation and abstract can be accessed using this PubMed database. If you want to look at the, or if you want to access the full length paper, you need to have the subscription. Similarly, we also have another database of literature, Web of Science, that requires institutional subscription in order to access the articles. So, since the literature is available in the form of database, anybody, whoever wants to design their research problem, they can look at the literature available on that particular problem. So far, to what extent work has been done, that can be studied by literature survey, and you can understand to what extent that problem has been worked on, and later based on those literatures available, one would be able to design their research problem. That's how this literature databases and retrieving the literature from these databases has been very, very important. Bioinformatics tools are required in order to maintain these databases and also to retrieve the literature from these databases. So this is what is definition or the introduction about bioinformatics. I hope you understood what is bioinformatics. The whole bioinformatics has emerged as a new branch of science in order to manage the large amount of information which is produced out of these genome sequencing projects. All this information is maintained in the form of biological databases. We also have bioinformatics tools available which will enable us to retrieve the information from these databases, and various tools are available in order to analyze this data. We also discussed about various applications of bioinformatics, what are all the different fields in which bioinformatics can be applied. We discussed about sequence analysis methods, phylogenetic analysis, pharmacoinformatics, what else, agri-informatics, the application in agriculture field. These are all the various applications where you can apply bioinformatics. Thank you for your patient listening. I hope you understood the concept. Many more classes will be coming up. You can access this video through Campus Technology. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts through the link of course chat. I would be able to reply your doubts. Thank you very much.